Hello and welcome to the Illinois Sports Night's Shot Clock. I'm Nathan DeHaan, joined by Anthony Pasquale from the Champagne Room and Alex Aguilera from the Daily Illini. While Illinois fans' excitement has skyrocketed this season, the energy was quickly sucked out of the State Farm Center in last Tuesday's game against Michigan State. When star guard Ayo Dosunmu goes down with a left knee injury in the closing seconds of the game, Illinois falls by just 1 point to the unranked Spartans. Illinois likely crash out of the top 25 rankings now, and although the MRIs show that Ayo Dosunmu's left knee has no structural damage, there's still no timetable for his return. Going right into it, we're going to talk about Illinois' upcoming road trip against Rutgers and Penn State. Anthony, I'm going to start with you. In that road game and not knowing Ayo's, you know, state of his health, who needs to step up and why?
I think, for me, you look no further than guys who are already in the starting lineup. Obviously, Georgie Bashanishvili needs to play better, but I'm looking at Trent Frazier to really step up. In his first two seasons, he was a prolific scorer for this team, and while he has been great on defense this year, the scoring has kind of just slipped out of his game. I know it's still in there. He's one of the best players on this team. He needs to show it on the upcoming road trip.
Understood. Alex, what do you think?
Well, for me, you know, I'm not too worried about Trent Frazier. Even though, yes, his scoring has dipped a little bit, you know, I think he's a guy that has shown in the past that he can score when he needs to. And now that he's going to be the guy with Iowa, he'll be fine. For me, it's going to be Kipper Nichols. He's only averaging 3 points a game. You know, he's averaging, what, like 2 rebounds a game. So I think that's a guy coming off the bench that, you know, needs to step it up so that they can get that spark off the bench.
Alex, I understand your point, but I'm going to give the point originally to Anthony here. I agree that, you know, as Trent Frazier has looked great on the defensive end, you would like to see some more offensive input from the junior. Alex, I'll start with you on this one. How important are these next two games at Penn State and at Rutgers?
They are major, Nathan. And when I'm talking major, I'm talking like major.
Sure.
But I think more than anything, it's got to be that Rutgers game. I mean, granted, you know, Penn State's a really good team, but I think if you can get a road win at Rutgers, this is a team you've seen before. This is a team you beat before. If you can get that win, you know, you get off that skid. And hey, even if you get a loss at Penn State, that Rutgers win, you know, helps you a ton.
Understood. Anthony, your take on it?
Yeah, I think no matter what, you have to go into this road trip and get a win, whether it's Rutgers or Penn State. You got to come home without a 5-game losing streak. I think that's the biggest thing you got to take away. I think the Rutgers game is probably a little bit more winnable because, like you said, we did see them before. And I think the Penn State win would look better if they were able to do that. But without Ayo, there's no really telling which game is going to be easier to win. I just think no matter what, you have to win one of those games.
Anthony, as much as I agree with you, I'm going to give the point to Alex because, I mean, you brought up how hard it's impossible to win at Rutgers. They are such a good team at home. I think that win at Rutgers would actually look even better than the win against Penn State just because of how great of a home team that they have been. Anthony, I'm going to start with you on this time. It's been really hard to gauge where this team's at and what this team is really good at. They just keep seeming to win games, obviously not recently,
right.
But going back to that 7-game winning streak, Anthony, what is this team's biggest strength?
I think the biggest strength is the depth that they have, and I think that's going to be especially apparent for however long Ayo Dosunmu is out. Even in that 7-game winning streak, I think the two biggest components of it were Alan Griffin and Andres Feliz, who were coming off the bench and performing. Now probably one of those guys is going to be in the starting lineup, and then a guy like Tevian Jones, who got some minutes against Michigan State, and Kipper Nichols, who also needs to step up a little bit. Getting those guys on the floor more, I think, might actually be a good thing for this team.
Understood. Alex, what's your take on it?
All right, well, as much as I love Death as the next guy, I'm going to have to go with these turnovers, okay? Turnovers, they're forcing other teams to turn over the ball at least 12 times a game, all right? So I think that opens up, you know, the transition game for this team, which is, I think, they're at their peak when it comes to offense, you know, is the transition. But then once again, that comes from turnovers. So I think, you know, when you look at strengths, it's got to be turnovers.
Yeah, and Underwood preaches turnovers in the way that his teams play defense, really force turnovers. But I have to give the point here to Anthony. I think that this team is really deep, one of the deeper teams in the Big Ten, if you ask me. Alex, I'll start with you on this one. You know, going to the starting lineup now, you've seen a lot of struggles out of Georgie Bashanishvili recently.
Yes.
And really, to start, I mean, 0-6 to start the game against Michigan State on Tuesday. What do you do with Georgie Bashanishvili if you're Brad Underwood?
I mean, well, one thing, obviously, you can cut minutes. I mean, when a guy's not performing, you know, you have to put your foot down and say, hey, if you want to get these minutes, you got to play better. But I think for me, honestly, is that I haven't seen him enough in the post. And I think that's where he flourished last year, was in the post. So, you know, if he can get more opportunities there, if Kofi's out, or, you know, just dump it to him like he has with Kofi Coburn, you know, he should be fine.
Understood. Anthony, what do you think?
Yeah, I mean, I agree with that aspect of it. I think he's been on the perimeter far too much, especially in the beginning of that Michigan State game. There's no way he should be taking your second and third threes of the game. He's just not that guy for this team.
Sure.
I think I would keep him in the starting lineup, though, especially if Ayo is out, because you don't want to have two brand new faces into that lineup, which has kind of developed some chemistry over time. I think just cutting his minutes and sending him that message that way, maybe he doesn't start the second half like against Michigan State. I think that's the way to send a message, but not ruin the the chemistry that they did develop.
Understood. Anthony, as much as I agree with you, Alex, I like the point that you make to try to find him in the post more often. And I mean, that is really where he excelled so much last year. Well, four questions ending. Look at that. We're all tied up at 2-2. Anthony, I'm going to start with you on this very last deciding final question. How would you like to see the minutes? I mean, you talked about it a little bit in that last question, but how would you like to see the minutes sort of split and shared over this last, you know, over this stretch that Illinois is going to go with?
Yeah, I think if you really look at this team, there's two spark plugs that I identify, and it's Andres Feliz and Alan Griffin. I know I mentioned both of them in my previous answers. I think the way that they both provide not only driving ability, but also the three-point shot, and they both just gravitate to the ball to get rebounds. So getting those guys in there a little bit more consistently will not only open up scoring for them, but for other people, for maybe Trent Frazier to get into it, or Georgie if he's in the game, and it should open up Kofi down low. So I think getting those two guys in the game more is the best thing to do.
Understood. Alex?
All right, well, you know what? As much as I was going to say that, and Anthony, thanks for stealing my answer, I'm going to have to go a little bit with Tevian Jones. I think that's a guy we haven't seen enough. I think that's a guy that has great athleticism. Granted, he's questionable on the defensive end, but I think that's a guy that opens up the floor and can create different scoring opportunities. So I think just, you know, giving him more minutes, you know, unfortunately now that Iowa's out, I think that opens up the opportunity for him to get those extra minutes. And granted, you know, Feliz and Griffin have been playing well, and they deserve those minutes. But I think, you know, it's time to see a little bit of Tevian Jones because we haven't seen enough of him.
Well, there it is, five questions down, and I'm going to give this game to Alex. I think I agree. Tevian Jones, I mean, I think he needs more minutes. I think that he spreads the floor, as you talked about, different scoring opportunities. And, you know, Illinois hasn't been that great of a three-point shooting team. Tevian Jones gives you that opportunity from beyond the arc. But that is going to do it for us here at Illini Sports Night on this episode of Shot Clock. Thank you guys so much for tuning in, and thank you guys.